If you've ever thought about Instagram automation or scraping the platform, you've definitely encountered Instagram proxies. If you want to know why you need them, how they work, and which ones to choose, this is the right video to watch. At the end of the video, we'll also give you some important tips for how to automate your Instagram correctly, so stay tuned till the end. This video is jam-packed with valuable info. If you want to grow on Instagram, it's usually a lot of work even with one account. All the liking, commenting, and posting takes a lot of time. But Instagram bots, such as Javi, Viral Igniter, and others, let you quickly grow multiple Instagram accounts, follow or unfollow, and automatically engage with your followers. Similarly, by using scrapers, you can scrape valuable data from Instagram, such as hashtags or user profiles. Unfortunately, Instagram is very strict about bots and scrapers. If it notices that you've made too many actions at once, or that suspiciously many accounts are working from the same IP address, let's say your phone, then it simply blocks your account or temporarily forbids you from liking and commenting. This way, Instagram fights spam. But automation is still possible if you get a good Instagram proxy server and select subtle automation settings, which would let you grow without making Instagram suspicious. But wait a minute, what is an Instagram proxy? It's an intermediary between you and Instagram or any website on the internet. This intermediary is usually some other device connected to a web somewhere in the world. For example, a phone, a computer, or even a smart fridge. The only thing that matters is that this device has a different IP address to your own. If you want to understand better how a proxy works, watch this video. The link is in the card and in the description below. Okay, if we need proxies for Instagram automation and scraping, then which proxies should we choose? After all, there are so many types of proxies and so many different providers out there. Instagram automation experts agree that the best type would be mobile proxies, also called 4G proxies. However, it's the most expensive option. For comparison, the same provider can sell residential proxies for $3 per gigabyte and mobile proxies for $15 per gigabyte. It means mobile proxies can be 5 times more expensive. So, we'd recommend searching for 4G proxies when you have a lot of experience with Instagram automation and a good strategy in place to grant you the biggest return on your investment. The best budget option for Instagram automation and scraping is residential proxies. They are a more common type of proxies. Many providers offer them, and therefore the price is much more competitive. If your provider sells peer-to-peer residential proxies, where all users share the same pool, it's much harder to ensure that the IPs won't get banned. Still, with networks spanning millions of residential IP addresses, the odds are pretty good for you. Time out! Before we go deep into the rest of proxy options and tips for using them, let us know in the comments below. Have you tried scraping or automating your Instagram already? Comment it? Okay, back to the smart talk. An honorable mention would be IPv6 proxies, as some automation experts mention them among the top 3 options. Surely, IPv6 proxies have some advantages. For example, it's easier to find virgin IPs, those with no prior usage history. That's because, in general, there are many more IPv6 IPs than IPv4. For the same reason, they are cheaper. However, only a few proxy providers sell IPv6 proxies, and it's hard to use them if you have no experience with proxies. And most of such proxies in the market are data center IPs, which means that you could get banned just because another IP from the same subnet got blocked. In general, data center Instagram proxies are long past the glory days, and you won't accomplish much with them. But some private data center proxies are dedicated specifically for social media. They are cheaper than both mobile or residential proxies. They are not the best choice for Instagram bots, but still useful for running scraper Instagram accounts. Speaking of affordable proxies, let's choose the best proxy provider that would suit your Instagram needs and see if we can make it even cheaper to you. After watching this video, visit the Proxyway website using the link in the description below. It will lead you to the blog post where you can find some discount coupons or free trials to try out the providers we mention. One provider we like a lot is Smart Proxy, and for good reasons. It has a large rotating residential proxy network that allows targeting nearly 200 locations and doesn't share subnets. VIPs come from both desktop and mobile devices. SmartProxy offers great customer support and plenty of content on Instagram automation. Just read their blog. This proxy provider is simple to use and it doesn't cost much for what you get. prices start from $75 for 5 gigabytes, which is $15 per gigabyte. All in all, it's no wonder why Smart Proxy is such a popular choice for social media automation. But Smart Proxy isn't perfect for everything. These are still peer-to-peer residential IPs. You can create sticky sessions for up to 30 minutes, but they will rotate. You also can't target VIPs by carrier or ASM, though that isn't a must. Here's a list of the most important Smart Proxy features. And if you don't like reading, just watch the Smart Proxy review instead. If you're willing to invest more, there's Luminati, the largest proxy provider today. It offers every kind of proxy there is. In our case, we're interested in Luminati's static residential and mobile IPs. Both come with country and city targeting, and the mobile proxies even let you choose the carrier. Overall, you can use Luminati both for account creation and management, and if you get peer-to-peer residential IPs, scraping as well. A good thing is that you can pay as you go. It's more expensive per gigabyte, but doesn't tie you up in monthly plans. The drawbacks? Well, Luminati costs a lot, and choosing useful features like ASM targeting adds to the price. For example, the static residential proxies cost from $20 per gigabyte, plus 50 cents per IP. The monthly plans charge cheaper per gigabyte, but that means you have to commit to paying at least $500 per month. The whole user experience can be confusing at times, and Luminati is very strict about compliance, so one day it can simply refuse to serve you for the things you do on Instagram. It used to have a landing page on the website specifically for Instagram proxies, and now it's long gone. If you're interested in Luminati, here's the list of the most relevant Luminati features, or you can find a full review using the link in the description. For quality seekers interested in precise geo-targeting, there's GeoServe. It is a VPN and proxy provider that sells both rotating and static residential proxies for Instagram. Its pool is small, but carefully picked and maintained. We confirmed that by running extensive performance tests on the rotating IPs. The results were good, and the proxy server stable. Sticky sessions up to 30 minutes make even the peer-to-peer option suitable for account management, though you should probably pick the static proxies for that. GeoServe allows choosing from over 1,000 cities for precise location targeting. But quality proxies come at a price, and GeoServe is one of the most expensive providers in the market. Its residential IPs start from $450, even higher than NetNut, which we'll discuss in a minute. Once again, it boils down to how serious you are about Instagram marketing. If you want to know more about GeoServe, you get the gist. Here's a list of GeoServe's features, or you can find a full GeoServe review using the link in the description. The next proxy provider, NetNut, sells static residential IPs, basically data center proxies registered with an internet service provider. They are hard to detect and don't need to rotate, which makes NetNut a good choice for account management. The provider has a dedicated pool of proxies for Instagram, so they should work well. Starting at $300, choosing this provider is quite an investment, and NetNut doesn't hide that it targets companies with large needs. It's also not very beginner-friendly, but if you're serious about Instagram marketing, or consider reselling, NetNut is one of the stronger candidates for the task. Here's a list of the most important NetNut features. For more information, you can find the link in the description below. For Instagram scrapers, there's a proxy provider dedicated to that, Zeit. It offers a rotating proxy API called Smart Proxy Manager for scraping all kinds of websites, including Instagram. These are only data center IPs, but don't let that fool you. Smart Proxy Manager includes all kinds of proxy management features to make them excel. It automatically throttles and retries requests, assigns browser headers, and more. This greatly simplifies work with proxies, and you only have to pay for successful requests. The prices start from $29 for 50,000 successful requests. Of course, Smart Proxy Manager is only good for scraping Instagram. You won't be able to use it for running Instagram bots. To save the proxies from bans, it can sometimes be slow, and cheaper plans limit features, like the number of requests you can make. Otherwise, it's a great option for anyone that wants data from Instagram without worrying about proxy management. Here's more features, and if you're eager to learn more, a link to the full review is in the description below. Let's not forget an honorable mention among Instagram proxy providers, HiProxies. Back in the day, HiProxies used to be a major provider of Instagram IPs. Javi, one of the most popular Instagram bots, even recommended it as the best choice for Instagram automation. But time passed, Instagram got increasingly protective, and today the provider's data center IPs have fallen out of favor. So now, if you watch an old video on YouTube about Instagram, and you hear about HiProxies, you'll know the whys and the hows. It can still be used for scraper accounts, and the price starts from $3.20 for one IP address. Here's some more features if you're interested. Okay, You know what a proxy is, you know what type you need, and you've selected your provider. What's next? Well, of course, you need to know how to properly use the proxies. We don't want you to get action limited or your IPs blocked. First order of business, how many accounts should you connect to one proxy? The answer is easy. One proxy, one account for residential IPs, and up to 10 accounts for mobile proxies. Technically, you could use a proxy for more than one account, but it's risky. Several of your accounts could get shadow banned at once if they are connected to the same proxy and make suspiciously similar actions. Second of all, consider your needs. If you only want to run 2 or 3 Instagram accounts with your Instagram bot, then maybe you don't need proxies at all. There are some Instagram bots which are called manual bots because they don't require proxies. The same goes for virtual private servers. They can help you run hundreds of accounts, but you don't always need one. Choose your automation tool. There are many different Instagram bots out there. Javi is always a popular pick, but you can also get FollowLiker, StoryVoter, Ninjagram, or Instagram Story Viewer, to name a few. Instagram automation software is as important or even more important than proxies. Also, some Instagram automation experts advise to get a proxy IP near where you live. Start slow. If you're growing Instagram accounts, let them warm up for a while before you do anything with them. Then, gradually start increasing the number of follows. You won't be able to reach 400 to 1000 follows a day anymore, but 1 to 200 is perfectly possible. Mind your actions. Don't run your Instagram bot round the clock. Instead, use it within a certain time frame, like 12 hours, because that's what humans do. Run your accounts in shifts. In the same way, don't follow, unfollow, or comment at the same time every day. It's a sure way to get shut down. Try things out. Check if your Instagram proxies work with trial Instagram accounts, play around with the settings of your Instagram bot, get used to the process. Test, 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 and don't stop learning. If you've been running multiple Instagram accounts with no issues until now, it doesn't mean things won't change. The platform constantly updates its algorithms, and the game starts all over again. So if someone makes a video about what Instagram settings he or she used 3 years ago, it doesn't mean it will work for you today or at all. Always test and adapt. Stay up to date by reading newest blogs, forums, and watching videos. One of your learning sources might as well be this YouTube channel, so subscribe, because in the next video we'll review Javi, the famous and at the same time infamous Instagram bot. See you in the next video.